This is my message. Leave us alone. Leave us alone or we're coming for you and we will get you out of your position. We're done.
Well, they're coming for you. Just a mere sample of the left reacting to yesterday's painful defeat. But it certainly doesn't end there. Union leaders are hitting the panic button and resorting to some downright dangerous language. Now, first, we bring you an incredibly reckless prediction courtesy of the Teamsters president, Jimmy Hoffa.
This is just the first round of a battle that's going to divide this state. We're going to have a civil war in this state.
Civil war. Hoffa's threat of this is just the beginning. As we reported last night, the Reverend Jesse Jackson also appears to be planning a mass demonstration, and here's what he is threatening.
These workers in this state must not fight back and draw a line in the sand. That's why I'm going to invest a major one-day strike, maybe a major one-day march on Washington for jobs and justice.
The prospects of a civil war, nationwide strike, and perhaps only thumped by the disgusting death threats that are being leveled at Michigan Governor Rick Snyder and his family on Twitter. For example, one read, "I want to shoot Governor Snyder in his eye." Another lists the names of the governor's family members and closed by saying, quote, "You blank our families, we kill yours." Joining me with reaction from townhall.com, it is Katie Pavlich and Fox News contributor Leslie Marshall. Good to see you both. Thanks for being with us. You know, union violence is not new. We've seen it before. Occupy violence, we chronicled that. G8, G20, all these summits. You see the radical left come out. You see a Tea Party event. They're putting their hands over their hearts. They're pledging allegiance, singing God Bless America, and then cleaning up after themselves. But the media goes out there and they try and play up things that didn't happen. Why is there that double standard? And what do you say to the violent people on your side?
Well, I have seen violent people on your side, Sean. I remember during the Affordable Care Act legislation, when it was passed, before it was passed, it was being debated, death threats.
Where?
What do you mean, death threats? On voicemail of congressional members, of Democrats. Oh. Some of them even left being in Congress because they were like, I'm done with this. This is, Sean, either way, left or right, violence is wrong.
I don't remember this. Katie, do you? I don't remember. I remember Andrew Breitbart.
Right. Yeah, go ahead. Andrew Breitbart offered $100,000 for video evidence that any of that occurred. So I think that those allegations are pretty reckless without any evidence.
No, it was an audio on voicemail.
Where is the audio, Leslie?
After the show.
But okay, I'd be happy to take a look at that. The fact is that there have never been riot police at a Tea Party rally. I've been to multiple of them. I've been to union rallies. There have never been threats of violence. There have never been anyone who's been punched in the face. And I want to focus tonight on why this occurred, Sean. Why was Americans for Prosperity targeted here? Because there was a very specific group who had their tent torn down. If you'll remember, President Obama has made the conservative Americans for Prosperity enemy number one since the day they started 4 years ago. He's been touring around the country for years saying Americans for Prosperity is a group that unions should be concerned about. He told unions they should be concerned about them. Why? Because he wanted them to know that when they showed up at their union rallies that they should be a target. Not to mention, just a couple months ago, President Obama was pressuring Americans for Prosperity to release their donor pages so that the names of the donors to Americans for Prosperity would be public, so these types of union people could go and intimidate private citizens. This is something President Obama set up, and it's something he's not willing to take responsibility for, despite going to Michigan the day before this violent rally and giving them his full support.
Now look at this violence. Look at these shots that they're taking. Look at the tent that's being knocked down by these union thugs. I worked in the restaurant business, Leslie, for years, construction, every job imaginable. I did this for decades of my life. This was not a short-term thing. I have a blue-collar background. And, I just don't understand this. Why not just allow people to choose to be in the union? Why not? Why do they have to force them to be in, force them to pay, and not give them the choice of whether or not they want to be in?
I'm all for choice, as you know, across the board.
So
I don't support when you benefit from what a union does provide.
So you're going to force them or else they can't work?
You know, when somebody's worked in blue-collar fields, Sean, you know that the union protects you from the big corporations.
Excuse me.
The union fights for you.
Did you see the video?
And the union's going to be fighting for people that aren't paying dues, and they're going to benefit from what union workers are paying dues for. That's not fair.
Remember the guys that were smoking pot on the job and drinking? Yep. They just got rehired. you know, I never had union protection in all my years in construction. I never had any protection in my years in the restaurant business, washing dishes, cooking, waitering, bartending.
You didn't have any protection?
None.
No regulations?
None.
At any of the construction sites of the restaurants?
No union.
No health care for you?
No, I was not a union construction worker. You know, I fell off a roof.
You should have been. You would have had the protection.
I broke my arm, dislocated my arm, busted up my teeth, Katie, and you know, I was basically told to be on my own.
All right. Well, Leslie says that unions fight for things. Well, we sure know that now. We have evidence that they literally do fight when they don't get what they want. But the fact is that unions are going to lose $100 million over this. And when you take away their money, they throw temper tantrums and they get violent. And the fact is that when people are given a choice to either join a union or not, they choose not to join. So they don't want these benefits. They don't want these protections.
Why would you
unions can provide them to the people
last
who
question.
Want them, but you shouldn't force people into it.
Why force them? Why? You've legalized stealing when the government, through the unions, force people to do this or they can't work. Why do you want to allow legalized stealing?
I don't look at it that way at all, Sean. I look at it as a choice of, do you want to go work for a union worker? I am. Or do you want to go work for, there are plenty of companies that aren't union shops. Don't go work for a union
shop. Who are you to say you can't work there unless you do what we say?
And you know what? We do have choice. And as consumers, we'll see what happens. We'll see if there's a division in Michigan.
You can't say you're pro-choice.
I am. I'm pro-choice as to what I buy and from what companies and what type of workers they have.
Oh, and I'm sure every liberal hires union shops. Oh, well, where do we get into
I don't speak for every liberal. I speak for me.
Right. And you only hire union.
Well, I actually have mostly union workers for those jobs that have a union, but for those jobs that don't,
yeah.
All right. Guys,
if
good to see
Jesse Jackson gets his way, we're not going to have places to shop because people won't be working.
And
it's a choice. You can shop at the places that are hiring non-union employees, and I'll make the choice as to what corporations I want to back based on what their practices are.
Good to see you both, Katie. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.